Blues came from gospel, gospel to blues. Old school, new school, there's no school rules. Ladies and gentlemen, I go by the name John Abuya, and I'm with my homeboy
Osumbanu in the right here. Y'all know we got the city and lockdown. This is still Solid Media, where we bring you the best, I mean, right in the world of pop culture. So what's up?
Today we're going to be talking on a topic, which is a gospel musician.
Are they creative?
Creative.
First off, you know, what do you feel about that?
Well, gospel, to me, they bite, they never write, and that's not polite. But the truth is, gospel musicians, they're not a native of creativity. What do you feel?
Are you? I really would like to say that a fallacy of hasty generalization, probably because some sections out of them are probably not creative. They try to, you know, they try to refurbish, you know, old songs and all that. But you saying gospel artists, you know, gospel musicians are not creative, I think, for me, I think it's not right.
Okay, let me
say most of them, maybe 80-70% of them are not.
Okay, if we're going to place it on a scale of 100, I'll say maybe 40% of them are creative, but the rest of them are not, because we have to take a look at back in the days. You know, we had the Orthodox Church, we have the Catholic and the Anglican. You know, when they give you songs, they'll give you all these gospel songs that are in the hymn book that comes with songs of slavery, songs that are inspired by God Himself.
Yeah,
but compared to this, our generation now, look at what happened recently. Tunde Edwards, you saw something that he had to put a song out and show you the throwback of the song, and it's a gospel song that it's even making waves all around town. But you see, they are not creative. They don't sit to write, and they bite.
I think most of them are just probably
they copy overlifting, copying other people's song. You know, it's so easy to make a gospel track right now.
Okay.
You pick from A, put from B, then merge it together. Especially Nigerian musicians, I have a problem with them.
I think most of them are just trying to, you know, cut corners, just trying to make money, quick cash and all that. And they think probably because out there in the mainstream music world, gospel artists are not really making it.
Can I ask you a question at this point?
Yeah.
Do you feel mainstream artists are making more hits, more songs, and they are more creative than gospel musicians?
Well, man, that's the pure truth. I mean, lots of...
So now you can say something like Davido, Wizkid, they are really trying, they are creative.
We don't really see much of them. I mean, most of them, you know, recycle songs, pick songs from way back, from this, from A, from B, from C, and merge it together. We don't really see them do that, you know, often. But men in the gospel world, you know, gospel
is the in thing.
I think that's the in thing. Lots of them, you know, pick songs from way back.
So what are the way out?
But really, the way out is just for them, you know, to settle down, you know, go back to the drawing board and look where they are going wrong. I mean, the wrong steps they've been taking and all that, and just try and, you know, up their game and all that. And one thing is that most of them are actually in there for the money, probably, and for the fact that maybe lots of people around them knows that they are Christians and all that, and they don't want to go the secular way. They tend to probably go the gospel way, just to cover it up and make money and all that. And that's why most of them are really not creative. The passion is not there. Most of them, I will tell you point blank right now, music wasn't their calling, or music is not their calling. So they just, you know, try to delve into that just to make money and all that.
Okay, so do you go with this point? These few points I'll raise. One, it says they don't reflect. They don't do deep reading. They don't study the scripture.
And that's one truth. You know, if you tend to probably have a debate, probably a Bible debate and all that with most of these, you know, gospel singers, I tell you, most of them would fail.
Okay. What about the issue of they don't travel? They're not well exposed.
Well,
that means they don't go to places like Jerusalem just to see.
Well, sure. Yeah.
You know, people tend to say when you're exposed, when you go out, you tend to meet people with different culture. And then you can sit back and write.
You probably might be right about that. And at the same point, I don't really think it's necessary for them to travel before they can actually be very creative. Probably some of them might not have the means probably to go out there to Israel Jerusalem or countries like that, you know, historical countries like that, they probably might not have the means, but sure, they can educate themselves by viewing videos. We've seen lots of videos, you know, Bible commentaries, you know, videos about the lives of the apostles and Jesus Christ, and lots of them. They sure can watch most of these videos and get some creative.
I can't even believe Extra is the one now going biblical now talking about Jesus Christ here and there. Okay, so all our audience out there, actually, I think if they sit back, study the word, deep reflection, read books.
I tell you, man.
Go to church, hear the words, hear inspirational words. Even there are some pastors that preach, you know, you can just get a word out of it.
Out of their head.
Instead of you just stealing, biting from here, biting from there, uplifting, stealing a line. You know, they say making hits is easy. Just take a famous hook.
You,
like Jesus loved me, yes I know, and put it on a song and just mix it up.
You're blown.
And you get to blow. Okay, to all our fans,
we wish them good help. But you still can join in right there on the conversation on our Twitter and Instagram page, right there at C Solid Media, and we sure would get to, you know, converse and together as regards to the topic right there.
Okay, to all our fans, we wish you good health in mind and body. May your life flow with milk and honey. Entertainment is loaded. Hurry, come make this money. NBB, what up, Sherry? Nigerian Billionaire Boys Club. Y'all know we run these. And you know, everything will eventually come to an end. So trying to save the moment, because time flat done it. We're building our likes. You got to make it last for the better, because nothing lasts forever, you know? Nothing lasts forever. I got to go. And I still remain John Odia.
And I'm Otumba Nunume. You can actually follow me across all social media platforms, Twitter, Instagram, and man, I sure would follow back. See you again on next episode.